What is going on, Alpha Hunters? Hope everybody is having a very wonderful hump day Wednesday. The market's having a pretty decent day. Not exactly the bounce back day you would really want to be seeing if you're trying to be bullish. You bought the dip yesterday. But it is a nice bounce today. SPY is up 0.5%, and it kind of makes sense. Yesterday we were kind of talking on a live stream that, hey, you know, if we see the sell down kind of continue as we go further into the afternoon, like, people are going to try and buy the dip. We were getting pretty close to the 20 moving average EMA, on the daily time frame. And, you know, if we kind of bounce by the close, or if we bounce early today, just expect it's probably going to be happening sometime soon. Well, the last 30 minutes, 35 minutes of yesterday's price action, we got a very strong bounce. Let me just zoom out, just show the whole thing here. So, yeah, I mean, we rolled over, and you can see how strong that rally was there at the end of the day. It was pretty sharp. It was pretty quick. It was pretty deadly if you're trying to be short right there. So, nice little gap up today. And it's kind of just been a sideways day. Not too much has kind of gone on. A little bit of a bullish pop here. Kind of first hour to start the day. Second hour and maybe an hour and a half there. Just kind of just rolled over. Down to the daily lows. Nice little push higher here over the past couple hours. A little bit of a quick pullback there. Intraday, I mean, this looks like an inverted head and shoulders. Got a little shoulder neckline head. Kind of another neckline right here. Shoulder there. We tried to break out here. Well, we did kind of break out of that neckline there about 30 minutes ago. But we are definitely rolling back down here. So, either we're retesting into that neckline and we're going to bounce as we go into the end of the day, or maybe we roll over. Now, there's been some other things that have kind of price action that has moved in other areas of the market today that have not been exactly the best. When you look at how the SP 500 SPY has performed today, we'll look at some of that. Anyways, the Qs, kind of the same thing. Nice gap up, kind of traded sideways. Not too much different from the open. Qs are currently up about 0.6%. IWM is getting a little bit of that buyback. It got absolutely annihilated yesterday. Currently up about 1.9%. You can see it's pretty much sideways there for the first half of the day. And then here the past couple hours, nice little bullish trend. Yeah, nice gap up there on IWM, looking pretty good. DIA, a little more of a choppy kind of breakdown kind of throughout the day. Kind of interesting. You can see that inverted head and shoulders kind of pattern here. So, it's been negative a few times throughout the day. So, DIA, not exactly doing all that great, just barely positive. RSP, up 0.6%. Nice gap up, kind of just chopping throughout the day. Not too much indifferent from where we opened at. So, there you go. That is how kind of they look on the intraday. See how we look on the day. A nice little, push higher here in the RSP. Kind of nice little lower wick there yesterday. Not doing too much today. Kind of mentioned it yesterday. You know, you're probably going to be moving your stop loss is below either the low of yesterday, or maybe if we didn't finish yesterday with a strong rally and we broke down just a little bit this morning, you're probably going to put your low below to this morning. Well, we actually had a pretty good rally right there at the end of the 30 minutes, last 30 minutes there yesterday. So yeah, that's probably where you're moving your stop losses right now. It's definitely so on the SPY and Qs. We'll take a look at that. But yeah, here on the RSP, it makes sense as well. If we break that, you're probably just looking to come down to the 50 EMA, which is not too far below it. I expect some kind of bounce down there if we do get down there, but depending upon how long it might take, like if it happens soon, I would say your stop losses are probably set below today, or you're probably just moving your stop losses below the 50 EMA. You say, hey, you know what? I don't mind giving up, maybe a point here. Because we do bounce off that 50. I don't want to be like I got triggered out you know, getting below some of these lows. And that makes sense. I can understand that on the RSP. RSP just looks a little bit different than some of the others, that's all. DIA, you're definitely moving stop losses right below the low that we put in yesterday. That makes sense. A little bit more room here to fall down to the 50 EMA. So, makes sense to probably put your stop losses below that spot. IWM hasn't really broken this 50 EMA. It's bounced off it twice. Almost got to it yesterday. So I'd say you probably have maybe stop losses maybe back below this low. Yeah, that's kind of what I'd be saying. Maybe below the 50 a little bit. Around like 191 and a half or so. Yeah, I don't know. IWM is a little bit tougher. But I can understand having a little bit more of a loose one. The Q's obviously bouncing off the 20 EMA again. This is one where I would definitely be having stop loss just below that level. Let me right about there. So that's where I would have it. Stop, boom. And that's probably just where you're looking to have your stop losses there for the Qs, because we're not, I mean, not to say that we're not up and positive and looks like we're having a kind of a good day, but I mean, I'm just now looking at the market. I mean, when I was talking about the Qs just a bit ago on the intraday, we were up 0.6%, and now we're only up like a third. So we just dropped off there a little bit. That's kind of the other thing is like today we're just not seeing the consistent, like when we bounce back over here the day after, look at that nice follow through, bullish, bounce back over here. We got the bounce the next day, you know, it's not looking like we were going to roll over. It was looking pretty good. Here we bounced. Well, we got to follow through back in the bullish direction. So once you finally get the bounce, the next day should be strong. And we're not seeing that today. Not to say that maybe we don't see that by the end of the day. But for now, I would just be saying stop losses below yesterday low. That's where I would have them. Because if we break that down, maybe by the end of the week, possible, then, yeah, you're probably talking about we got a pretty good air pocket, at least down to the 50 here on the SPY, 50 EMA, that is, and then back, maybe back below, you know, probably back below this low as well, or at least down to that level. That's a pretty good pocket there. It's a pretty good pocket. So, anyways, that's probably where you're looking to have stop losses. Now it's not saying, you know, we break that level where you're going bearish. I think, you know, if we take out this zone, then maybe you could talk about looking at bearish setups or something like that. But for now, I wouldn't worry about it. And here's the other one, AAPL. Now, you know, I've not been a bull on AAPL for much of the past 2 years, mostly because I feel like they just don't have great growth prospects in the areas where tech is growing, right? And that's, to me, that is the problem with AAPL. It's just they're getting mature. That's it. They're not a bad business, but people don't go chase. You know, you don't see rapid rises in stock prices unless they have good growth prospects, right? NVIDIA, for example. So AAPL being down over 1% today when the market's up, it has been up positive all day, and AAPL just continues to sell down. It's at the lows of the day. That's not the best look. It's just not a great look. So this is going to be a very tough one for the market to kind of overlook, as this is still one of the largest weightings on the stock market. And you see the Microsoft's barely negative. This is another one that's not performing all that great. Kind of getting sandwiched in between here in the 10 and 20 EMAs on a daily time frame. Kind of just neutral there for the day. Definitely could see us breaking down here over the next day or two. So you get the two largest stocks out there in the stock market, not exactly looking great. AAPL, people seem to be done with it. I mean, maybe like retail investors that have poured money into Apple over the past 15 years. Maybe they are continuing to do it, but Microsoft also not looking all that great. You know, I think big time investors are looking at them and like, yeah, you know what? They don't really have, especially on AAPL, they don't just have the greatest of growth prospects going forward. Microsoft, to me, has a little bit more defensive growth kind of going forward. I wouldn't say like aggressive growth going forward. But anyways, it's kind of the way I look at those two, and just kind of the stock market, you know, being positive when you have the two largest stocks out there. Actually, not even positive, you know, negative. AAPL's down a pretty good amount. Take a look at the VIX. VIX coming back down. Whoa, VIX had a pretty good spike yesterday. Wow, VIX did get... That's... Oh my gosh. This is what's so concerning on the market. It's just how much... Like, I mean, the market was down 1.5%, 2% at the lows yesterday. 2% at the lows yesterday. I don't even know why I said 1.5. It's about 2% at the lows, maybe a little bit more. And it's just like the VIX just like went into crazy panic mode. It's like we didn't even break major trend levels. This is, yeah, just such an interesting time. People are so ready to hit the panic button for any kind of pullback. It'd be really interesting to see what happens going forward if we do see some bearish moves. Anyways, VIX seen a little bit of a pullback today. Maybe the VIX is breaking out here, which would be really weird because typically VIX is not leading the bullish, the VIX does not lead up too much. The VIX will typically, okay, so the VIX in like normal market topping patterns, the VIX will bottom before the stock market tops. But the VIX will not explode higher before we see massive downsides come from the market. It's basically kind of what I was trying to say. So, anyways, this is a very interesting move on the VIX yesterday. I didn't realize it got as high as it did. I kind of looked at it yesterday, but on the live stream, I didn't look at it later. That's a pretty crazy move there. DXY, pulling back a little bit. I'm going to go intraday here because... One thing I want to show you here, 15-minute time. You know what? I'll go to 5-minute. So right here is about when the stock market opened. You see the dollar's pulling back basically throughout the day up until about an hour ago. Pretty steady pullback. But, you look at the SPY, and it's like the SPY hasn't done anything. You would have thought the SPY would have been bullish off that dollar move. And yet, it's not. So... That's kind of what I was alluding to starting out of. There's some price action here going on today that should be more favorable for bullish movements throughout the day. And we're just not seeing that in the stock market. So, just kind of interesting. Anyways, dollar pulling back. Gold also down a little bit. Not really doing horrible. Kind of more flat than anything else. It's kind of interesting that gold is down a little bit, but not a huge move, so not a big deal. Yields is also one, just like the dollar. You know, look at the 5-minute. You know, nice, steady decline, basically from about 30 minutes of the market open, 30 minutes before the market opened, to about an hour ago. Like, we just saw a steady decline. Again, the S&P 500, well, we didn't see no steady rising. We saw a little bit of pop there in the first hour. But outside of a couple of uptrends throughout the day, I mean, we just haven't really done a whole lot. It hasn't been a greatly strong bullish day. Just mostly just been on the gap side. So it is one that, for how much yields have pulled back yesterday after they exploded higher, I would have thought we would be at least up a little bit more from the open, the stock market open. So. Yeah, we'll see what happens here in the next couple days. That's one reason why I would say just I'd be moving up some stop losses because the market, in my opinion, should be up a little bit more. Maybe we do trade a little bit higher here over the next day or two. I'd be curious to see what the yields and dollar do also over that time period. But it's almost like the yields breakout yesterday, dollar breaking out yesterday, is something that caught a lot of people with concerning eyes. So we'll see how things go here over the next couple of days. Yield, 10 and 2 inversion yields. Bouncing back a little bit today. A little bit of a drop day yesterday. Bouncing back a little bit today. So that means 2 years definitely dropping off pretty good there today. 2 year was really strong yesterday. HYG bouncing back today. Did not really get and solidify that breakdown. Traded a little bit lower than that move to start out the year back in January. Did not hold it. Still kind of in this consolidation. Maybe it is starting to break down though. Maybe we'll see a breakdown here over the next week or two. We'll see. LQD has definitely broken down. Nice little bounce action today. Although, you know, yields are down pretty good, so you'd expect the bonds to be up a little bit. But the LQD has been breaking down here over the past week, so it might just retest higher and break down. So that, I mean, that doesn't look good for bond yields either. So TLT bouncing a little bit today. Maybe just retest into the bottom, this January bottom here, and then maybe roll over. Just kind of a resting day. Yields had a very sharp move yesterday. So it's not like there wasn't a great a reason. You know, it's not like, you know, overcoming yesterday's move is going to be like a one-day affair. Yesterday's move on yields was very, very strong. What else? Let's see. Sector rotation. Let's see what is the winners of the day. Okay. We got staples underperforming pretty good. Energy's also underperforming pretty good. You got healthcare underperforming a little bit there. In line with the market, utilities, tech, financials, and discretionary is kind of all wrapped in there. You also got materials outperforming, real estate, communications. And industrials, best performer of the day, up 1.2% on the day. Look at that. All right. Industrials doing pretty good. Underperformers, taking out the gap, no gap. Underperformers intraday. Energies, which is kind of surprising because energy is actually leading the day to start the day there. So XLE underperforming there. Staples also underperforming. Tech underperforming during the day. Outperformers, materials, healthcare, financials, utilities, communications, and real estate, as well as discretionaries and industrials up at the top end of the day. It's kind of just a mix mash. I'd imagine a lot of people trying to figure out what the heck just happened yesterday and trying to rebalance stuff. So there you go. Let's take a look at some commodities real quick. Take a look at crude oil. So crude oil made a nice little run here for about a week and a half. Maybe it topped. We're going to have a contract roll tomorrow, so be mindful of that. And the other one I really wanted to show, there's two I really want to show, but gasoline had a contract roll yesterday. And for all of those that might be concerned with rising gasoline prices, you will probably see a rise in the pump prices, as we had a contract roll of about 25 cents higher. So expect gasoline to probably go higher here over the next maybe day, or maybe you've already seen it go higher. Anyways, yeah, there you go. Gasoline up pretty sharply on the contract roll. Jeez. Also, heating oil. Heating oil has not yet gotten to its contract roll. It'll come up here at the end of February, but nice little drop off there today. Heating oil dropping pretty good there. Another one I really want to show off, though, was copper futures. Copper's been dropping pretty good here for the month of February. You can see how much has really been dropping. If you don't know the significance of copper, copper is very much a highly watched commodity because of the economic activity it kind of foretells about. If there's not much economic activity, copper does not do well. Kind of is a little bit of a recessionary forecast. If copper's doing well, then, you know, people are buying copper, expanding the economy and all that kind of stuff. So traditionally, legacy has been a very good tell for how the state of the economy, I guess. So anyways, copper not exactly doing the best year so far in February.